Exciting news for Walmart sellers. Now Walmart is allowing you to set up your own brand store on Walmart. Actually, it was launched in February 2024 and some sellers had the private beta access to it, but now it's live after so many updates. So just like Amazon, now you can create your own brand store on Walmart, showcasing the breadth and depth of the brand to your customers. Just look at this brand shop. Look how impressive it is. They have added banners, categories, promotional banners, and a lot more things. Awesome, right? Previously, it was possible only with some third parties, but now it's completely free and now you can do it yourself. Three simple steps. First, apply for the brand shop in the advertising portal. Second, register the brand. This is the same process how you apply for the brand register on Amazon. And finally, build your brand shop. Let me show you how you can apply for it and design your own brand shop on hand. So first, go to advertising.walmart.com/business/brand shops. Now here, you'll see, let's create a shop builder account. So we'll have to create an account here. Tell us about yourself. So I am a seller. So select I am a seller or a supplier. I'm not a partner or agency. So yeah, I'll select that. Next. Now here, what can shop help you to do? So you will get some basic idea from here. And so all these things, like it will tell your brand story, promote your products to the million of customers, and feature top collection and categories. Like you will have another option here that is called brand shelf. So we'll discuss this further. And here, so this is the seller ID linked. I can see here, and then click create account. So once you click here, your partner ID will show here, seller ID, your seller name as well. And the third thing is, do you want to use the data from your advertiser account for Shop Builder? Yeah, I do that. So I'll select yes. And then continue. Choose your admin, first name, last name, and email address here. And also, if you want to change your admin to for Shop Builder, then you can click here. But I don't want to change this. I want to remain the same. So click next. And from here, review your information, all the data, partner ID, seller ID, seller name. And yeah, do you want to use the data from your advertiser account? Yeah, I do. And then admin name, first name, last name, and email. So everything is done here. Let's click on the submit. So yeah, now it's done. And Walmart will review this information and they will get back to you on email. Yeah, we are on it. So the onboarding has been done successfully. So now we'll have to apply for the brand, the second step. So register your brand with us. So here you can see three different options. So in the middle, third-party sellers, register your brand with us. So we will click here, register brand. Okay, now here we are in the new window. So in the Walmart brand portal, now we'll have to register here. So if we click on the register here, so we can see the register option, use seller central account. I will use that. And through this, we'll be able to log into Walmart brand portal. So here's the welcome screen, and let's start. So all the information are here. It automatically comes from Walmart, and a few details that we'll have to upload here. The first thing is the business registration number or something like that. So here the company information. So we'll have to confirm this one. So we'll have to attach a document. Now that is like the traditional, the trademark document, trademark license or anything for your brand. So you can upload it here and then continue. And if you select continue, it will go to some brand details, write down your brand name and everything, and finally submit. So I have already done this one, so I don't want to show this right now. That's the actual process. And once it's done, Walmart will email you that your brand has been registered. Then you will be able to log into your brand shop builder account and you can build your shop. So that was the first and second steps. So now we have the access and we'll go to the shop builder and we'll see how it works and we'll create a demo store right now. Let's check it out. Okay, first log into your Walmart Seller Center account, and here in the top, click on the Ad Center. So we will go to the brand portal from this Ad Center here. So on the left top, you can see the sponsor search. If you click here, drop down, you will see the sponsor search and shop builder. So we'll click on the shop builder here. So basically, this is the backend of the shop builder, and we'll have option to register the brand from here, and we can create a page like the full brand, as well as we create a brand shelf. So actually, the brand shelf is showcasing the categories or the items in the categories. So we will show that in the later in our next video. But yeah, right now I'll create a great page. So we can see there are three different options. So from here, we can get some tips to create a great page. So if you see on the top right, create a page. So we will directly go to that. So if you click here, we'll have two options, brand shop and brand shelf. So currently we're gonna create a brand shop. So let's see how it works. So here is the dashboard. So now we'll have to input the brand name, the shop name here. So let me write the brand shop name here. Okay, so the title and description, they will be automatically here, so we don't have to do anything. And just now click next. So this is the main dashboard. So from here we'll have different options, like we can design the each part of the store. So here if we see the spotlight, currently it has four different options here, but if we click on the select your sections, then we can we'll be able to add more sections here. But right now I want to see only these four sections, how it works. So let's start with the hero banner first. So these are the requirements, 16:9 ratio, and the image should be PNG or JPG or 10 MB max. So let's upload the image. And it's done. Let's add some alt text here to describe the image for the people with vision disabilities, or spell out numbers 1, 2, 3, etc. So yeah, I'll add some alt text here. Now the second option here, the text. So in the text option, we'll have to add a headline and a subheader here. So the headline we'll have to add within the 22 characters. We'll add this one. And the subheader. Okay, you'll have to use a sentence case and end with a punctuation. So we'll write this, yeah, within the 60 characters. Done. So here are two other optional options here, like eyebrow headline and legal disclaimer. So we don't want to show these for now, so we'll keep them off. Okay, so the next option is the button. So we can add a single button, we can add multiple buttons here. So see, let's see what happened. So if you click on the single button, we'll have an option to add the button text and the URL link. So we'll add the shop now button, and here we can have two options, create a new shelf and link it up, or we can manually insert a link. So currently we're not creating any shelf, so we'll manually insert a link here to shop now button. Okay, I'm adding a category link here. Okay, now the fourth option is logo. It's actually optional, but yeah, we have a logo. Let's add this here now. So our first hero banner section is done. Now, secondly, the category hub. This is required and important. So we will add the categories, some important categories here. And if we go this section, we'll have to, here currently we have four different category option and the section. So we'll give a section name, which is the popular categories. Yeah, let's write popular categories here. And four different categories we can add for right now. As you know, we don't want to add any other sections right now. So let's see how it works. I'll give the category name here, the area rugs. The second one is bedding. The third one is kids luggages. And the last one is there will be kids bedding. Yeah. Now we'll have to add the category images. So for the area rug, so these are the requirements, 1:1 ratio images. So let's add the images here. So for the area rug, this is fine. Let's add for the bedding. Okay, so we are selling some satin sheets. So we'll add the banner image here. Yeah, for the third one, let's add the luggage picture. Yeah, this is done. And the finally, kids bedding. This is done. So if we select your sections from the left side here, you will see you can add more category hubs. So if you have multiple categories, you can add from here. But right now, we're going to keep only these four. And let's add the image alt text. Now we'll have to link up the categories. So for these area rugs, we have a link for area rugs from our store. So one thing, if we had the brand shelf, we can directly link up those shelf here. But as we didn't create those yet, we will use the product link or the category links here. So let's add these links here for all these four categories. Yeah, this is done. Now on the third section, item carousel, and it is required. So we'll have to add some items carousel here. We can add multiple carousels, but no, we don't want only one for now. And let us give a carousel name here. I'll showcase only one category item here. So I'll name it area rugs. And here from here, let's select the items. So we have two different options. We can directly search with the name and we can directly search with the item ID. So we can see the area rugs are here. So we just, for instance, we're gonna add some of these. Let's see how it looks. And later we can obviously modify it. Okay, see, items are added here. Okay, it's done. And the final option, promo cards. So if we have any promotional banners, just like the 50% discounts or 10% discounts or any promotional banner, we can easily add here to attract more customers. It will look good. So we have multiple options for promo and promo cards, but once at a time we can add up to three. So here we'll have to add three card. We'll have to add three different promo cards here. So let's say the card one, this one. And we can add the text, headline, subheader. Okay, let's add, let's upload the image. And okay, headline, subheader, image, alt text, and button text. And we'll have to add the link, and we'll have to add the link here. So let's do it for all these three. We will add three cards. Okay, so far this is done, and let's click on save and preview. So let's see how our store will look right now with these all these changes. Yeah, it is definitely good. Shop with confidence. Yeah, okay. The banner, popular categories. Yeah, we named it popular categories, and the categories. Okay, I think it would be better if we can add more categories here. But yeah, we already decided we'll add these four. Okay, if we go down, item carousel, area rugs, and the my promotional banners. Yeah, that is really, really good. So now, this is done. And if we see the mobile view, how it looks. Okay. So once we submit the store here, Walmart will review and it will publish. And if any issues, they will let you know. So that's all. So in the next video, I will show you two things. I will create a brand shell from the scratch, and I will create another store, and I will add all the sections and see how it looks. Once your brand shop is up and running, now it's time to track the performance. Walmart Ad Center provides different matrices to measure the performance of your brand shops. Matrices like number of visitors, total views, number of units sold will help you understand the performance of your brand shop. By the way, customer can be directed to your brand shop directly through the media campaigns like sponsor ads, offsite or onsite ads, or any kind of ads, as well as other media activations. That's all about Walmart Brand Store. So if you need any assistance, you can reach out to us at info@ecomclips.com. This is Murtuja from Ecomclips. At Ecomclips, we help sellers grow their business, and our goal is to increase at least 30% sales in 3 months. So if I give you an example here, I'm managing this account from last few months, and see, in the first quarter, we have increased the sales at 57% compared to the last year. That's how we work. See you in the next video. Till then, goodbye.